So, good morning, one and all. So, let us start today's class with some other topic, that is conditional PDF and expectation given an event. So, this similar type of discussion we have done in case of discrete type random variables. So, here we got a conditional PDF on an event A. How we denote this? F of x given A of x. Now, it depends upon it is conditioned upon an event A. Okay. Now, so that is the conditional PDF. This is the conditional expectation. Conditional what? Expectation. How it is defined? This is a simple formula. So, what is the actual formula of expectation in case of continuous type of random variables? Integration minus 2 plus infinity. X into fx of x dx. But so here we are writing, instead of PDF we are writing conditional PDF, CPDF. It becomes condition on event A, as simple as that. Okay, so you must know these two formulas. So this is a formula for conditional event. Conditional expectation, sorry. Okay. Now, so we have a total expectation theorem. Same theorem is being discussed in case of discrete type of random variables. Everything is same. Only thing is we write PDF in place of PMF. So, rest is same. Okay. Now, this is the PDF. This is the expectation formula by using total expectation theorem. So the theorem is exactly same. You once study both at one time. The theorem in case of discrete time, in case of continuous discrete, in case of continuous type of random variables. Okay. So based on this, we'll solve a problem. Now here is a problem. So we are finding the mean and variance of a piecewise constant PDF. I have mentioned what is the piecewise constant PDF. Okay, it is constant in pieces. Okay, now it is defined like this. Suppose x is a random variable that has got piecewise, it has got PDF like this. Okay, and we have got two events. So from this we have to find out the mean as well as variance by using what? So we have got two events and one PDF. What do you use? How to calculate expectation? You have to calculate the probability of those events and you have to calculate conditional expectation. If you know conditional expectation and the probability of events, you can get expectation. Not only that, for variance, what do you need? Expectation of x square minus mu square, I mean mean square, right? So how do you get this? You can get from the same formula. We'll solve this problem. Okay, you read the problem properly. They gave us a PDF and two events. So based on that, we have to find out their expectation and their variance by using total expectation theorem, using this theorem. Okay. So let me draw the PDF first. They gave the PDF like this. So it is 1 by 3 and it is later it is 2 by 3. This is 1 over 3. This is 2 over 3. 0 to 1. Sorry. This is 0 to 1. 1 to 2. This is x. This is the PDF. It is not conditional PDF. It is simply PDF. Okay. Now, and we have got two events. What are they? Event A1 says that. What is the event? So, x lies between 0 and 1. 0 less than x less than 1. Between 0 and 1. Next, A2. What A2 says? X lies between 1 and 2. Isn't it? Now, so what is the probability of A1? How to get probability of any event? It is simply area under the PDF. So what event A1 says? It says that the random variable X is between 0 and 1. So we have corresponding PDF. How to get the probability? Area under PDF. What area? Up to this. Between this area. This area. What is this area? 1 by 3. Suppose if I ask you what the probability of event A2. Event is A2 says that X lies between 1 and 2, which means this area. So this area gives you P of A2. This is P of A2. This area gives you P of A1. This is P of A1. What is P of A1? 1 by 3. What is P of A2? 2 by 3. Directly I am writing. That is 1 by 3. P of A2 is 2 by 3 over. So we got the probability of events. Next thing is, you have to find out. Okay, first of all, so what is the, suppose if I ask you, what is this PDF? X given A1. It says that X lies between 0 and 1. So which is uniform PDF? From A to where? 0 to 1, this is 1. Okay, this is the conditional PDF of event A1, or this is a conditional PDF over event A1. What is that next? F of X given A2, which means what A2 says, X lies between 1 and 2. It is also uniform PDF from where to where? 1 to 2. Obviously, what is this value? 1. So these are the two conditional PDFs on an event A1 A2 respectively. Both are uniform. Okay. Now, just now in the last class, we have discussed the mean of uniform PDF, uniform random variable. How much is that? So let me write here mean or expectation of uniform random variable between A and B. What is that? In the interval A to B. What is that mean? Mean or expectation of a uniform random variable in interval A to B. What is that? That is A plus B by 2. This is the mean or expectation of X. What is the expectation of X square you got, if you remember properly? Second moment. That is A square plus AB plus B square whole by how much? 3. So you just recall them. So why I am asking them is because here we have two conditional PDFs which are in uniform, which are having uniform PDF. So if I ask you from those two figures, please be patient. If I ask you, what is the expectation of X given A1? Before that, so let me write the formula. What do you write formula? X given A1 0 to 1, X into F of X given A1 of X to dx. So instead of calculating from this integral, I am just asking directly, because we know the formulas of mean of a uniform random variable. If this is A, this is B, what the mean? A plus B by 2, that is 1 by 2. No need to calculate this integral itself. You just write 1 plus 0 by 2, that is 1 by 2. Yeah, you can calculate from this integral also, you'll get same answer. You do it. Suppose if I ask you, what is the expectation of X given A2? What is that? So we are talking about second type of conditional PDF, which is also uniform from 1 to 2. Now A is 1, B is 2. What is that? 1 plus 2 by 3. Sorry, 1 plus 2 by 2. That is 3 by 2. We got the conditional means of a1, a2. Next, if I ask you, what is the x square given a1? Please, I am asking second moment. What is the formula? A square plus ab plus b square by 3. I am talking about f of x given a1. A is 0, b is 1. Substitute here in this. What do you get? A is 0 means 0. B is 1. Ab is 0 by 3. That is 1 by 3. Now finally, what is the second moment of expectation of x square given a2? But in the second case, a is 1, b is 2. So let me write clearly. 1 plus how much? 4 plus 2 by 3. That is 7 by 3. That is 7 by 3. Now, here, so from the total probability theorem, what is the expectation of x? What is that? P of, two events are there. P of a1 into expectation of x given a1 plus P of a2 into expectation of x given a2. I know all the values. I am substituting directly. Okay. So P of A1 is 1 by 3 into 1 by 2 plus 2 by 3 into how much is this? 3 by 2. That is 7 over 6. Okay. Now, suppose in the same way, if I ask you, if I make it x square, what will happen? Same thing is valid for x square also. So means you get second moment, same way. Okay. So expectation of x square equal to P of a1 into expectation of x square given a1 plus P of a2 into expectation of x square given a2. Now substitute all the values. You know all the values straight away. That is 1 by 3 into 1 by 3 into how much? 1 by 3 plus 2 by 3 into how much? 7 by 3. You calculate this. How much you get? That is 15 by 9. Yeah, you can simplify further. But I want variance, no? What a variance of x says? Expectation of x square means 15 by 9 minus mean square. What is the mean? 49 by 36. That is 49 by 36. You calculate, you get the answer. That is 11 by 36. This is a variance and this is a mean. How much is the mean you got? What is the mean? Where is the mean? You got a 7 by 6. This is the answer. 7 by 6 is the mean. And that is the variance. Okay. Yeah, you can calculate the mean directly also, but I am using that total expectation theorem problem. That's it. So otherwise you can do directly. So let us take one more problem. Okay, so this problem is somewhat interesting. So please pay your attention here. So read the problem properly. A metro train arrives at a station near your home every quarter hour. Quarter hour means 15 minutes. For every 15 minutes, there is a train. Starting from 6 a.m., which means, so every 15 minutes, you have a metro train starting from what time? 6 a.m. Which means at 6 a.m. you have a train. Next at 6:15 you have next train. At 6:30 next 6:45 at 7:15 7:30 so on. At every interval of 15 minutes you have a train. It continues. These are the timings of a metro train. Starts from 6 a.m. Every 15 minutes you get a train. Now what happened here? You walk into the station every morning between 7:10 and 7:30 a.m. Every morning you walk into the station. Every morning you go to the station between 7:10 and 7:30 a.m. with the time in this interval being a uniform random variable. Okay. Now what is the random variable? X, let us call. What is X? Okay. So these are the timings of the metro train. Now here X is your arrival time. X is your arrival into the station. It is a random variable. What type of random variable? Uniform random variable into the station. Now, so when you go to the station between 7:10 a.m. to 7:30 a.m. every day you go to the station between 7:10 a.m. to 7:30 a.m. regularly, and that time is modeled as a uniform random variable. The time is modeled as a uniform random variable. Now, so next, what is given the problem? What is the PDF of the time you have to wait for the first train to arrive? They are asking what is the PDF of the time you have to wait for the first train to arrive. So they are asking for the PDF of a random variable, which is time. That is the waiting time. How much time you wait until you get into the first train? Okay. So let us call y as a waiting time. It is also a random variable as a waiting time. How much time you wait before you get into the first train? Waiting time. Okay. Now. So here X is mentioned as a what type of random variable? With a time interval being a uniform random variable, which means you go to the station every morning between 7:10 to 7:30. That is modeled as a uniform random variable. Obviously, so if that is a uniform random variable, you can draw the PDF. I hope you can draw the PDF. Is it okay? Now your entering time into the station is modeled as uniform random variable. So please pay your attention here. You enter from where to where? 7:10 to 7:30. That is uniform. 7:10 to 7:30. Now the time of your entry into the station is being modeled as a uniform random variable. So what is this gap? 20 minutes. Obviously, this is 1 by 20. This is your fx of x. Is it okay? Correct? Yeah. So definitely, you go to the station every day morning from 7:10 a.m. to 7:30 a.m. Now, so there can be two events. What are they? So let me check the timings of the train. Yeah. So train started 6 a.m. You get first train at 6 a.m. Next 6:15, 6:30, 6:45, 7. So you won't catch any of these trains because why? You are entering at 7:10. You are entering between 7:10 to 7:30. That's it. So you may catch only these two trains at 7:15 train. 7:30 train, isn't it? There are two events are possible. Either you may catch 7:15 train or 7:30 train. Is it okay? Because this is your PDF. Here you are coming at 7:10. You may get 7:15 train or 7:30 train. There are only two possibilities. I will call them as events. I hope you are okay with this. Event A. What it says? You catch 7:15 train. That is event A. When it is possible, when you catch the 7:50 train, when you come between 7:10 to 7:15, whenever you enter the station between 7:10 to 7:15, then only you can catch 7:15 train. Okay. So here, so event A is defined something like this: when your arrival time is between 7:10 less than equal to x less than equal to 7:15. Next, event B. Event B. You catch another possibility is you catch 7:30 train. Now, when it is possible, when you enter a station between 7:15 to 7:30. Is it okay? Is it okay, all of you? Here, so here 7:15 is included in this event. It is not included in this event. Okay, so we are maintaining the accuracy of the time. Is it okay? Now, so the problem is very simple. Now, the question is, so before that, now what is probability of A and probability of B? You calculate and tell me. What is the probability of A and probability of B? What is the probability of A? A says that x lies between 7:10 to 7:15. So to get probability, you must take area under PDF. So let me draw the PDF little bigger this here. Okay. So this is the PDF of your arrival time. So let me make it very big. Okay, it is from 7:10 to 7:30. Okay, so you want to find out which area this event A up to 7:15. What is this area? What is this value? 1 by 20. This is 7:15. 7:10 to 7:15. What is this area? This is P of A. How much is that? What is P of A? 5 by 20. This is 5. This is 1 by 20. That is 1 by 4. I hope you are okay with this calculation. Now here, this is the area under PDF. It is P of B. How much is that? This is 7:15 means 15 by 20. I hope you are okay with this. Is it okay? You got two probabilities of events, P of A, P of B. P of A is 1 by 4, P of B is 3 by 4. 15 by 20 means 3 by 4 only, right? Okay, correct. Next. Now, what is Y? It's a delay time or waiting time. You may call waiting time. Now, what is there in the problem? What they are asking in the problem? What do you have to find out? Let me go to the problem. PDF of the waiting time. That is what they are asking. They are asking for PDF of the waiting time. Now here, so here, let me say like this. Suppose waiting time given on an event A. Can you tell me what is this? How it will be? How much time you wait given that event A? What is event A says? Event A says you catch the 7:15 train, which means you are waiting for how much time? So every day you may come at 7:10, between 7:10 and 7:30. Suppose if you catch a 7:15 train means, so uniformly what is the waiting time? 7:10 to 7:15, isn't it? So that is also uniform distribution. So this is a conditional PDF which says that you may wait for 5 minutes. Okay, you wait for 5 minutes, 0 to 5 minutes. This is a condition event A. This is 1/5. This is the FY of A. Now, one more conditional PDF. What is FY of B of Y? Which means how much time you wait if you catch the 7:30 train? How much time you wait? So you missed the first train, which means you did not come before 7:15. You might have come after 7:15. So your waiting time is how much time? 15 minutes. You would wait for 15 minutes. Is it okay? Your waiting time is 15 minutes. If you catch the 7:30 train means you might have waited for 15 minutes uniformly. Okay. Now, so using the same total expectation theorem, you can write Fi of y equal to, same analogy can be used, but you can write P of A into F of y given A of y plus P of B into F of y given B by y. Clear? So this, yeah, here you be careful here. P of A, P of E, how much P of A? P of A is 1/4. P of B is how much? 3/4. So can you calculate this? Can you draw this? I'm drawing this. You do this simple calculation. This is the PDF of the waiting time y. That is, it is 1/10, later it is 1/20. This is 0, this is 5, and this is 15. Here it is, this is 1/10, and this is 1/20. You calculate this. Fy of y, y. Now this is a PDF of your waiting time. Mathematically you can write like this. It is Fy of y equal to, it is 1/10, 0 less than or equal to y less than 5. It is 1/20, if it is between 5 less than y less than or equal to 15, 0 otherwise. This is a mathematical form of writing the your PDF. Okay. So that is the one more problem to solve. Okay, so we stop here, we continue in the next class.